Billy, a slightly unfamiliar view of the pitch from here, not one that you normally adopt, I think.
Not normally. I usually spend 80-90% of the game up in the stand, and I use the telephone if I want to get any information down to Dave Bentley. And because, as you can see, I mean, it's just all you can see is a forest of legs at this level. You can't really get a true picture about what's happening.
Must be agonising for you up in the director's box, though, sometimes, isn't it?
Now, funny enough, I'm camera up there, and I can take things into a lot of perspective up there. Where when I'm down here, you get wrapped up in the game down here. Where up there, you're a lot more calmer, and you can look at the game and a bit dispassionately.
Now, last summer was a very busy one for you, Bill. You signed 6 new players, really shaking up the whole place. But did you feel, having signed those players, that you had got the nucleus of a promotion side?
Yeah, it's always very difficult to say. You bring people in and you hope they're going to do a job, and some come off for you and some don't. That happens in every walk of life. But we knew we had, because they had been Leeds United, we knew teams would always play better against Leeds United than they do normally. We knew it was always going to be a difficult task. And when we got to the back end of the year, we realised then that we were still going to be short, because the players that we wanted were just out of our price range. So that's when I came to the conclusion that we had to sell Ian Snowden.
That obviously was crucial, that reorganisation, having sold Ian Snowden and bringing 4 new players in, but to react fairly quickly, didn't you, to the market situation?
That's right, but we also knew beforehand who we wanted. We had been negotiating with the clubs involved for about 4 weeks before that. We knew round about the price that they were looking for. Mickey's was straightforward enough. John Pearson was straightforward enough. Bobby McDonald, obviously. Mark Hazelwood took another, I think it was about another week or 10 days after that. That was the most difficult, because we still hadn't hassled over the official price. And once we got that sorted out, from there, I think we only lost about 3 games then. Up till present.
Did you genuinely feel when you signed these 4 players that there was still time for a promotion bid? Because it's perhaps rare for so many players to settle in so quickly to a team.
It is, but we had a good camp in the sense that it was a good camp. We didn't have any bad apples in the camp. They're all decent enough guys, and the 4 guys came in and we knew all about them and what the characters were like, and they blended in quite well. We got the results initially when they first came to the club, which always helps, and at the end of the day, they've helped us tremendously, and the team has responded as a whole, and we've got ourselves into the position that we've got ourselves today.
I know one thing that there will always be, while you're manager of Leeds United, is a constant throwback and a reminder to the great days of the 60s and 70s when you were the general on the field for Don Revie. Has that loaded with you with any extra sense of responsibility or pressure to, if you like, lead Leeds back in that direction from a different job here as manager?
No, not really. I mean, most of the lads who played in that era anyway have got a great affinity towards the club. I'm no different, and my big ambition in life when I took over first in management in Doncaster, my biggest ambition was to one day be able to manage Leeds United. I've got that opportunity now. It's up to me to make the best of that opportunity, because it's a dream come true for me, really, to come back to Leeds where I'd been a player and try to prove myself as a manager now.
You've certainly got the potential here with these supporters.
They're incredible. I mean, people say support can't, you only play the 11 players on the park, but here at Leeds United you don't, because they're worth a gold star, and they should be worth a gold star to us. And sometimes when we're playing at home or away from home and we're starting to dip a little bit, they seem to be able to sense when we're dipping, and maybe we're tiring a wee bit or whatever, and they pick us back up again. And I mean, I can't thank them much, how much they meant to us this year, and even last year when we were struggling, they pulled us through at the end of the day.